Welcome back, everybody. Shall we continue our explorations of Good Neighbor? Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Hey, Piper.
You know, I still really appreciate the fact that you're not an idiot.
Took you this long to notice, huh?
No, I didn't mean like... I could just use some help. This isn't the sort of thing I'd normally bother anyone else with, but you just seem really good with people, and I've got this issue with my sister, Nat, becoming me.
Wait, become you? Like, replace you? Oh, is Nat a synth?
Oh, well, there's something I'm gonna lose sleep over for days, but no, not like a synth. More like she's gonna start following in my perilous footsteps.
I mean, think about the life we lead. No offense intended, Lou, but personal safety doesn't exactly seem like either of our strong suits.
I can't have her ending up like her big sister. Dodging bullets and running from all the people she pisses off.
Give her a Gatling laser.
On the road so much. Part of the reason I'm here with you. I keep thinking, maybe if I make myself scarce, if I'm not around her enough, she'll cool off. She'll just go back to being sweet, innocent Nat, paper girl, and all-around upstanding citizen. What do I do, Lou?
You don't get to decide who Nat's gonna be, Piper. She does. All you decide is whether you want to be a part of her life or not.
You're right. She's her own person, and always will be. Thanks, Blue. Who'd expect wandering off with a stranger to turn out this well?
Stranger danger! Stranger danger!
You're a hell of a friend, you know that?
Just friends, huh?
I guess. I thought so. Unless, you know, something changes. Did it get hot in here? But hey, thanks again for listening. It's a real weight off my chest to be able to talk it out. So, you wanna hit the road?
Is there anything else that you wanna talk to me about,
hey,
Peeper?
You know, you look like you could really use this. These things have literally saved my life.
Nuka-Cola, really?
Hey, you. Looking for work?
Yeah, when can I start?
Well, aren't you a good neighbor? If you don't mind a little manual labor and don't ask too many questions, you're in. I'll give you 50 caps to start. Interested?
You can do better than that.
Fine. Take 100 up front.
This is just a bad deal.
You're killing me here. 150 to start.
Still not good enough.
200. And that's as high as I go. Jeez. I gotta watch out for this one.
I'm gonna need more to go on here.
There's a project I'm working on. A big one. One that could get me into lots of trouble if the wrong person finds out. So little discretion is called for. I got a delicate house of cards going here, you know.
Can you give me more?
That's the most I'm gonna give.
I'm in.
That's what I like to hear. Let's go.
Thank you.
No, I followed you down here for the exercise.
Funny. Well, you get plenty of exercise here. You are going to be doing some digging.
What are we digging for? Buried treasure?
You could call it that. But seriously, lay off the questions. The other two are down there digging already. Go give them a hand.
Bobby.
What is going on in my tunnel?
Looks like we are having crab for dinner tonight.
You'd eat Myler? Disgusting. Tough, but somehow slimy at the same time. Well, you stuck around at least. So I guess you're promoted. You get to be my new gun. I think we just need one more guy. An old friend. He'll want a fair cut, but we saw we'll be a cheap guy.
That means less caps for me.
Yes, it does. There's still plenty to go around in that strong room. Don't you worry. First, I think it's best if you actually see what we're after. I have some things to check on in Diamond City. Head over to the noodle shop there, and I'll meet you when I finish up my business.
It's a big dig.
Hancock says newcomers are welcome in the third rail. Go on in. Enjoy your stay.
I just wanted to talk to you. Well, I thought that's what we were doing. Now, there's something special about you, isn't there? Don't tell me. Let me guess. Ah, of course. It's those powerful muscles of yours. My. I could get used to looking at those. So what brings a woman like you to my part of town? Me? Playing a game. First idiot who grabs my ass gets his arm broken. 10 points if he's drunk.
That sounds like the beginning of a great song. I think you and I are gonna get along. So it's my turn to answer questions, right? What can I do?
I was wondering if we could get to know each other better.
Oh, really? Go on.
You, me, an evening walk under the streetlights.
And then what?
Music.
I knew you were something special, right? Let me get my coat.
Let's get out of here.
Let me get my coat.
My end customer's out.
Afraid my first love is always going to be the stage, though. I hope you understand. Just can't get too attached. But I'll see you around, good neighbor. When I'm up there singing, thinking.
Excuse me, miss.
I have to head back. I'll see you around, good neighbor.
Are you from Vault-Tec?
I am Vault-Tec. 20 years of loyal service, and now look at me. I wasn't on the list. But you, look at you. 200 years, and you're still perfect. How's that possible?
Well, you kill enough people. Sooner or later, something's bound to make you immortal.
Oh, that's rich. Real funny. Just like that robot of yours.
After the bombs fell and I came too, that bucket of bolts was still there, trimming those damned edges like nothing happened.
You met Codsworth? What did he say?
Welcome to our happy home, sir. Can I get you a drink? Cheerio! Just like that, over and over again. He was the only one still alive that I could talk to. A year went by before I couldn't take it anymore.
Yep, I must have set Codsworth's blind optimism levels to stunningly.
You know, you're the only other person I met from before. Oh, God. I've been so alone here. No Commonwealth settlement. Once a ghoul with 200 years of Vault-Tec Seals experience.
Hey, you know you could head back to Sanctuary. I'll come visit. I promise.
Really? You will? Okay, I'll head over there right now. You promise you'll come visit, right? I'll see you there.
Someone new. You need some jet, man? Homebrewed, reasonable prices?
You have any work?
Yeah, actually, you might be perfect. You know the gunners, right? The high-end mercenaries? Well, a few of them were talking about scavenging around that old hallucinogen building. I mean, just think about that name. There's gotta be some shit there that's out of this world. If you get me something, I pay you. 200 caps.
Your offer's a little low, friend.
All right, let's make it 250.
Not good enough. You said there's already a crew of mercs there.
I did say that, didn't I? How about 300?
Good neighbors full of chem addicts. You have plenty of money to fund this job.
Okay. You got me. 400 caps, that's all I can put out.
You said gunners are out there?
The blackest-hearted mercs around, friend. Well-armed, organized. So, you know, make sure they don't catch you.
Or, you know, I blow them up with a Gatling laser.
Anything more you can tell me about Hallucigen?
Like I said, that name's killer. They probably made all kinds of chemicals worth grabbing. The gunners were willing to send a team in there, and those guys don't go after lame marks.
All right. Fred, we have a deal.
You're the best. The absolute best.
Before you even start, let's skip to the point. We have rooms. One room specifically. Payment due up front.
Can you tell me a bit about this hotel?
Oh, why do they always have questions? The Hotel Rexford used to be a grand establishment. We even had guests that didn't throw up all over the floor. But now, the only people who come by are looking for somewhere to nurse a hangover or shoot up Kim's. So, still want a room?
Who owns this place?
Mr. Morawski. Oh, you should have seen him in his day. This place used to be flowing with high-end Kim's, beautiful clients, and oh, the parties! But now he just stews in the back office and disgraces his parents' memory. I swear, if they knew how far he's fallen, they'd die all over again. So why don't you rent a room before I get worked up?
Tell me more about this Morawski character.
Oh, why bother? He's worthless. The other big names caught him with his pants down, and now he just has this ratty hotel. That's the way Good Neighbor operates. The strong make it to the top until someone stronger kicks him down. Now, are you buying this room, or not?
Tell me a bit about yourself, Claire.
I have been working in this hotel for over 40 years, and this is not how I imagined spending my retirement. Now, are you done being nosy, or are you getting a room?
Let me think it over.
Make up your mind next time.
Wasted good bullets.
Oh, yeah. Could have done better yourself, huh? Well, I'm sorry you haven't had the lovely experience of killing a man who's wearing a friend's face. Now get lost.
Ooh. Pretty sure I have plenty to see.
Beat it, chump.
Hey there.
That was your... Next time? Don't piss me off. Still exploring the third rail.
Downstairs. Don't bother me. Stay free, sister.
Running from something? Welcome home.
You're blocking my light, doll.
Hey, Magnolia.
Looking for me? What can I do for you?
Do you know Imogene Cabot?
Imogene? Sure. I know her. I haven't seen her in a while, though. Are you a friend of hers?
I just need to talk to her.
Why are you looking for her, honey?
I'm trying to help her. Do you know where she is or not?
No need to get impatient with me. I just don't consider it polite to gossip to any stranger.
I'm not just any stranger.
Do you know where she's gone?
There was this preacher fella who used to come in here all the time. One of the slick ones. Always going on about remaking your life and so on. Most of the customers wouldn't give him the time of day, but Imogene. She latched on to him for some reason. I don't suppose it hurt that he was easy on the eyes. Intense. Some women find that irresistible.
Pam! Would you come over here a minute?
Is there a problem, Miss Magnolia?
No. This lady here was just looking for Imogene. Do you happen to know where that preacher fella came from?
Brother Thomas.
Yes, that's right. The one Imogene was always hanging on.
Had to throw him out. Wouldn't stop bothering customers with that salvation racket. Kept going on and on about joining him at the back bay. Then he'd shove those stupid flyers in your face. Here, kept one of them, just in case he didn't pay his bar tab.
Well, thanks, honey. You were a big help.
Any anything for you, miss.
I hope Imogene's all right. I didn't much like the idea of her going off with that preacher fellow.
We go. Seem to be doing pretty well. All right.
Hey.
Better keep your iron strapped on.
Yeah.
Can't say I'm surprised to find you end up like this one.
I was wondering how long it would take your bloodhounds to track you down, Whitlock. It's been almost 3 months. Don't tell me you're getting rusty.
Should we take this outside?
It ain't like that. I'm just here to deliver a message.
In case you forgot, I left the Gunners for good.
Yeah, I heard. You're still taking jobs in the Commonwealth. That isn't going to work for us.
I don't take orders from you. Not anymore.
Mungo.
Why don't you take your girlfriend and walk out of here while you still can?
What?
Mungo.
Winlock, tell me we don't have to listen to this shit. Listen up, MacReady. The only reason we haven't filled your body full of bullets is that we don't want a war with good neighbor. See, we respect other people's boundaries.
Really?
You know how to play the game. It's something you never learn.
Glad to have disappointed you.
Because you know, if you keep being aggressive, I can just shoot you full of holes right now.
If we hear you're still operating inside Gunner territory, all bets are off. You got that?
You finished?
Yeah. We're finished. Come on, Barnes.
Yeah, we'll talk to him later. How much more do I have to do to max out my relationship with Beeper before we pick up MacReady?
I toss out the troublemakers. Keep that vibe.
Hey there.
Here on Gunner business. So back off.
Really?
Charlie, serve the drinks. I do the drugs.
Stepped into the wrong place, sweetheart. You don't look like you need the memory den. Do you even know what we do here?
Does it involve a back room and a handful of singles? Like that ring?
Oh, you have the wrong idea, honey. I don't sell skin. I sell memories. And let me tell you, reliving an experience, the right experience, it's far more intense than anything else. But it's not for everyone.
You're cautious. I respect that. But I think I can handle it. If you'll just give me a chance.
Well, I suppose there's no harm in giving you a trial. Now, memories involving other people are easiest. Recent events involving loved ones. Does anything come to mind?
Try that one.
I can think of something, but I don't feel comfortable talking about it.
Well, if you don't want to tell me, that's fine. Just focus on it, okay? All right, sit down in the lounger. Let's see what memory we can find.
Okay.
Dr. Amari? Just find the strongest imprint you can.
All right. Scanning the hippocampus. I found something. Very recent. The sync with the temporal lobes is strong.
That's the one. Lift the curtain, honey. It's showtime. If I had any idea that we were going to put you through that again, I would have said no.
You step back and put me through that again. You owe me.
You're right. Here, a small consideration for everything we've been through. But honey, what you need is a detective. I have a friend, Nick Valentine. He works out of Diamond City. If anyone could help you find your missing child, it'll be him.
Hey, Irma.
Nick Valentine's helped a lot of people, sweetheart. Come on.
Your memories of Vault 111? I'm so sorry we put you through that again. Dr. Amari?
Don't bother asking me how the memory loungers work. I don't have time to teach the years of neurophysiology.
That was different. Pretty much talked to everybody here, haven't I? The only thing left to do is to break into a couple of warehouses and see what we can find in there. That was amusing.
Where'd you go?
Stop hiding. We'll make nice. Promise.
You say that, and yet you're gonna be the ones ending up dead, so
Freddy Cat.
You being mad at me doesn't really matter too much, does it? Thank you. bunch of mobsters. Not sure it was really worthwhile coming up here.
Stay there.
Got it. Not going anywhere.
What are you, an idiot?
Okay then. I won't hide from this. I won't hide this bullet from you.
Come out. Do you quick?
I'd rather not, but hey. How the hell do you know what I'm doing, Piper? You're on the bottom floor.
Heads up. Moving out.
Hey.
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 What's up?
Well, I guess we've done everything we can here. Including killing a few triggermen. Someone exploded. I'm exploding. I actually need to go south and south and east, I think. Combat helmet back on. I love that death scream. Yeah! Yeah. Well, I hope so, because, you know, you're probably gonna die. I hope you enjoy yourself before you die. I'll take out your leg. Thank you. I've got pretty much every limb crippled except for one leg in my chest. Go ahead, poke your head out. Will you actually let me target you, for God's sake? Give me a moment for that to register. Gonna taunt us with throwing knives, are you, developers? Ooh, control spotlights. It includes a spotlight hacking source. Interesting. Some big ass bugs. Wonderful. Grabbed a holotape, didn't even think to play it. Any more of you monsters want to pop out? So I can fill you full of energy. Giant Pip-Boy light? there is something up there. About to say, I don't think there's anything hidden here, but I was wrong. Drinking buddy password.
Since I had cold beer?
Very good. I appear to be operating at an optimal level. Shall we commence delivery to the Hotel Rexburg?
What are you?
I am a modified Robco Protectron designated drinking buddy. My internal microbrewers allows for the internal brewing, bottling, and dispensing of beer at an accelerated rate. I am also programmed to tell a wide variety of jokes for the customer's amusement. Shall we commence delivery to the Hotel Rexburg?
Can you brew any other types of beer?
If provided with a hollow tape containing the recipe, I should be capable of brewing any alcoholic beverage. Shall we commence delivery to the Hotel Rexburg?
No, not yet.
Very well. Standing by.
Oh.
Hey, buddy. I found a recipe for you.
Greetings, technician. Shall we commence delivery to the Hotel Rexburg?
Change of plans. I've decided to keep you myself.
Understood. Are you ready to set the parameter at this time?
I'm ready.
Very good. Please select the default location.
Ooh.
Ooh. Parameter accepted. Beginning transit.
This little guy's gonna be real popular.
Hey, buddy.
Greetings, buddy. Here for a laugh, or did you want a cold beverage?
Do you know where I can find any more recipes?
You might want to check with the distributor. Local bars and restaurants may also have one. Care to wet your whistle, or do you require a laugh?
Tell me a joke.
A communist, a spy, and a Chinese man walk into a bar. He orders a drink. Would you like a cold one, or did you want to hear a joke?
I'll take a beer.
Cold and refreshing.
Good enough.
Carry something before you cripple yourself.
send the drinking buddy to Hotel Rexford. Later. Later. Let me upgrade him as much as I can first. Alright, so our next location is follow the Freedom Trail. What else do I have on my map for things to do? We do have that. Investigate the museum. Explore the combat zone, find Nick Valentine, find Imogene, investigate the radio broadcast. So lots of stuff. I guess the next closest one is follow the Freedom Trail? No. Follow the Freedom Trail is such a annoying quest. Find Nick Valentine, combat zone. There we go. Tick, tick, boom. Actually, you know what I want to try? Inventory, weapons. As I set up so many of them, let's give this a try, shall we? That was kind of amusing. northwest, okay? Okay, let's see if I can do that. Just clear the way.
Someone there! I smelled your fear!
Sorry, General. We can't fire again yet. Give us a few minutes to recalibrate the artillery.
Alright, we'll just have to give them a few minutes. And then we'll see what chaos we can unveil. I love this weapon.
This is Radio Freedom, voice of the Minutemen. It's 6 o'clock. Attention, Minutemen. News has come to us of a settlement that needs our help. You
move.
Are in the area.
Piper!
Respond.
If you don't move, Piper, I will shoot you. Seriously, Sanctuary Hills and Abernathy Farms are the only places that go get these alerts. It's ridiculous.
Walking. Radio Freedom, broadcasting all day, all across the Commonwealth. Nothing to report at the moment. Stay tuned for updates.
Amen.
Well, they're gonna be like that, sure. Say hello to my little friend. Anyone wanna pick a fight? Anyone wanna pick a fight? Come on. Give me a reason to blow you up. Want to try and put me full, fill me full of holes? Yeah, I would agree. You've made a mistake, and now you're going to pay for it. Yes, I am working with, what's it called? Pleasant Hood, actually. And welcome, Hedro, to the madness. I love this weapon. I don't know how many times I can mention that before it sinks in, but good God. The never-ending legendary effect on the Gatling laser is just insane. It is literally the definition of insane. I have seen some insane weapons in my time. Definitely need to pick up Adamantium Skeleton the first chance I get. Because I get crippled way too easily. Sure you were. That's what they all say when they face a minigun.
Why don't you come over here?
That shoots lasers. Damn it, where are my sharks that shoot freaking lasers? I'll talk to you as soon as I'm done looting everything that isn't nailed down. You're now able to build potted plants at settlement workshops. That'll make Codsworth happy.
You finished tearing the place up now?
No, actually, I am not. So you can help keep your shirt on until I am finished tearing the place up.
You all done killing each other?
No, no, I'm not. I am not done killing each other.
You finished tearing the place up now?
You can keep asking me that. The answer is going to be no until I've got every single thing that you have here in my backpack.
You all done killing each other?
Is there still stuff that isn't nailed down? Then the answer is no.
You finished tearing the place up now?
Again, is there stuff that is still not nailed down that is not in my pockets?
Hey, you all done killing each other?
You keep saying it like that and I'll add you to my kill list.
Look,
just saying. Urge to kill contacts rising.
Look, whoever's out there, we were rooting for you the whole time.
Fun fact, I uploaded a new mod to the Nexus.
Why don't you come over here? Show us you don't mean no harm.
Yeah, sure. As soon as I've looted everything that isn't nailed down. I see you're in the cage.
You all done killing each other?
Soon. Very soon.
Why don't you come over here?
I mean, on the off chance. Alright, I have taken everything that isn't nailed down. There is not a single weapon that you could use against me. So.
So you wanna talk this out like civilized folk? Or are you just gonna is it over? Well, that could have gone worse.
I dunno.
It's called
performance from where I was standing.
Pleasant HUD.
High or something. Why am I asking? Of course you are.
We're still winning the fight, wasn't I?
You're strung out and getting sloppy, is what you are.
Of course, I suppose you ain't gotta worry about that now. Seems this one just put us out of business. I'm not sure if I should kiss you or have my little bird here feed you your own entrails.
I told you to quit calling me that.
Must say that again to my face.
Out of business? What do you mean?
Not the entrepreneurial sort, are ya? Keeping those idiots entertained was what kept us in caps.
Now just what the hell are we supposed to do?
To hell with them. More'll come. Just need a quick breather and I'm ready to go.
A breather? What? So you can slam more of that junk into your arm now. You know what?
As for the mod I uploaded, it's
You caught the end of that mouth. What'd you think of
case? What did I call it? Jackets, scarves, and gloves. which basically changes the gloves of Skyrim, jackets of Skyrim, scars of Skyrim, to use the same tags that my other mod is using, as well as allowing you to actually craft the scars at workbenches, and allows you to craft power armor frames.
Not sure. I didn't catch the whole thing.
Yeah, I guess you were pretty busy cleaning house. Impressive work. Makes me think you're good enough to do me a favor. So here's my predicament. I suddenly got no audience. No audience means I got no caps coming in.
And if you ain't bringing in caps, little bird, you ain't an asset. You're a liability. To me, and to yourself. So, here's what I'm thinking.
What say I let you take over her contract? She goes with you, watches your back. Look, you'd be doing me a favor while I try to get the place back in order. What do you say?
Me! And her!
Why would you want her to go with me?
Yeah, Tommy. Just why the hell are you trying to get rid of me?
Look, truth is, all that junk, it's been making you careless. And I don't want to be the one doing color commentary when you finally hit the floor. All right? So just do me this favor. Both of them. Please.
I'd like to know what Kate thinks.
Don't I get a say in all this?
That ain't how a contract works.
I did just ask for her opinion.
Stay here. No audience. No caps. No one to talk to. But yours truly.
Jesus. Point taken.
So, she's on board. Now what about you?
Not interested.
Shame. I usually got a pretty good sense for matchups. How about we say you'll think about it? You change your mind, we'll be here. You'd still be game, wouldn't you, little bird?
If it means not having to put up with you, she can't come back soon enough.
Good. Then it's settled. You decide you want to be paired with the best. You're welcome, anytime. Maybe we'll have the place cleaned up by then. Bring in a less bloodthirsty clientele. And yeah, the purse from the last fight. Consider it a retainer.
You change your mind, come find me.
Alright, well, when I'm ready for a new companion, Kate, I will find you. Right now, I want to max out my relationship with Piper. And then I've got to work at MacReady, and then I've got to work with, Nick Valentine after we eventually find him. And then we've got you, Kate. And we've got you. You guys gonna say anything new?
This ain't no place for you.
How about you pester someone else?
You know, I could kill both of you right now. With this. You sure you want to keep talking smack? You sure? Sure? Sure?
Buzz off. Hey, get away from me. I swear, if I wasn't tied down.
Eh, you're not worth the expenditure of energy. Besides, it's more fun watching you squirm. Pretty sure if I gave them a punch with my 11th strength, I'd kill them. Actually, I think I have more than 11 strength. Because I have a lot of fortify on my gear. So yeah, I have 18 base strength. Pretty sure if I punched them, their head would cave in. Find Nick Valentine. Find Imogene Cabot. Really, what to do next? We got that. Search for tech. Shaw High School. So the real, the real question then is, do I want to find Nick Valentine or do these things? Hey, Swan! Holy crap, I hadn't even noticed I was taking a huge amount of rads. Inventory. Well, hallucinogen seems to be the one closest to us. It's behind us. Let's do a full save. Sometimes you gotta go where everybody knows your name, and they're always glad you came. Sometimes you gotta go where the people coming long ways. Sometimes you gotta go where everybody knows your name. weapons workbench. Chemistry station. Well, probably wouldn't hurt. Oh, this is a weapons workbench, okay. Machete. Mental note, after you've taken an Ultra Stim Pack, keep an eye on your health. I literally died while at the crafting bench because of the Ultra Stim Pack's negative health effect. Oh, mercy. Those Ultra Stim Packs, I tell you. I know the cross bar is around here somewhere, I just don't know exactly where. Sometimes you gotta go where everybody is alive. What the heck is a security pool queue? We're gonna look at that one later. Got them all done. I think everybody knows Cheers intro. Because after all, it's where everybody knows your name. Alright. Well, I seem to be gaining health now, so. That's definitely going on my highlight reel. Oh my god. That one's not too bad either. Nor is that one for that matter. Okay, I have to admit, that's kind of cool. I have to go back up to the one we had before, because I need to take this as a screenshot for when I make the highlight reel. Okay. Mental note. Don't get so distracted by the funny that you forget you're still under the effects of an ultrast impact, and it will eventually kill you. It's the mod, it's the any weapon mod for any, it's the mod that allows you to use any modification on any weapon. Where is it? That's kind of interesting. That's kind of strange. Alright, I gotta do it. Because Ezra... I mean, I'll probably never use it, but I have to do it. The console command that allowed you to freeze even yourself. So what, set time scale, I think? That'll work. Set time scale to 0. Ah. So the ultrast impact kills you because, mainly, if we look at the ultrast impact, wherever the heck it might be in my inventory, so it gives you a massive amount of health, and then at the end of it, it takes away a large amount of health. And I think because I have Medic 4, all the negative effects are increased a lot of the positive effects. So, after giving you this huge boost of 2,250 HP, when that effect wears off, it does about over a long period of time, basically. But so far, it seems like the only thing that actually can counter it is the regular stim pack, which just gives you full health. Alright, now here's a good way to, here's a good thing to test. If I use the refreshing beverage, which cures all addictions, will that cure the negative effects? I think it does. Maybe. We'll see, I guess.
Welcome, neighbor. We're always glad to see a new face around here. Tell me something. Do you ever feel like this whole world is broken? Do you ever wonder why things can't be the way they were in the good old days?
The whole world is broken.
That's what I used to think. Until I found a way to make a difference. To transform my life. And maybe everyone else's too. We call ourselves the Pillars of the Community. We're a pretty new movement, so you may not have heard of us. But we're growing fast all across the Commonwealth, and you can be part of this exciting future. Step right this way, and I'll be happy to tell you all about our movement and how you can be a part of it.
I'm just looking for Imogene Cabot.
Oh, I'm sorry, but Imogene is indisposed right now. She's not seeing visitors.
Probably. Probably my own setup for chems.
Her family's worried about her.
You can tell them that she's fine.
Yeah, sure. I'll trust you, Synth Eyes.
She and I are just having a little relationship trouble. You know how it is. She's not seeing anybody until she cools off.
I'm a friend of the family. Maybe I can talk some sense into her.
Please, have a heart.
Look, truth is, we had a little, disagreement about her joining the movie.
If you've killed her, I will kill you with a pool cue attached to a boxing glove.
Figure out what to do with her. If you're willing to take her off my hands, let me unlock the door for you, then she's all yours. I've got a warning. She's way stronger than she
welcome.
Looks. Does she have 11 strength? Because I'm pretty sure I'm stronger. Just saying, I'm pretty sure I'm stronger. Because unless she has 11, unless she has 18 strength, I'm pretty sure I'm stronger. So tell me, does she have 19 strength? Because pretty sure I'm stronger than her.
She's all yours, neighbor.
It's a tarp, isn't it? It's a tarp.
Look at this place. The maid's got talent.
It's a tarp. It's a tarp.
I hope it's a tarp. We don't have anything to talk about.
You should talk to Brother Thomas about how to join our group.
Hmm.
Hello, neighbor.
Hey.
We're always looking for new friends.
Am I overlooking something obvious? Is this Imogene here?
I hope you decide to change your life.
We're always looking for new members. I hope you decide to become one of the pillars.
I actually didn't do this on my previous character.
We don't have
so I'm. So either the quest is bugged. Must get past. Look, dude, if you don't move, I will kill you.
Excuse me.
We don't have anything to talk about.
This sort of cleaning.
Why am I afraid that the save that I had before this? Before I did any of the crafting down. No. Good. Well then, I guess we'll ignore that area for now. Gonna die! Where is it? Yeah, I figured it had to be bugged because that's not how quests work, my friend. That's one Ultra Stim Pack from before is still trying to kill me!
Repeat, a chemical leak has been detected. Please evacuate the building immediately.
I can always look it up later. Are you supposed to be, like, making a jump over there? I don't think you can. Probably. Yeah, let's be honest, Piper.
Repeat. A chemical leak has been detected. Please evacuate the building immediately. Evacuate the building.
Nice.
A Ain't no thing but a chicken wing. If this chemical leak is making them all go crazy against each other, Piper probably doesn't have a very good odd of surviving this, given how often I accidentally shoot her in the face. I'm just gonna say it now, Piper. If I accidentally shoot you in the face multiple times with a Gatling laser, probably the chemical leak. Probably.
A chemical leak has been detected. Excellent. Please evacuate the building.
And it's probably not intentional. But I make no promises, Piper. Someone's got a stealth boy. Too bad, it's not gonna really help them if it's against a Gatling laser. Just saying. Yeah, she tried the stealth boy and was immediately blown to bits.
Please, evacuate the building.
I love the penetrator perk. Put the gun away.
Has been detected. Please evacuate the building.
A chemical leak has been detected. Please kill everybody in your vicinity. I mean, evacuate the building. Grab a note of some sort.
Repeat, a chemical leak has been detected. Please evacuate the building immediately.
Quite sure how to get over there.
Please evacuate the building.
Ah, door I missed. Piper, be careful. Don't shout stuff like that. Piper! Seriously, stop teleporting! And I thought there might have been something more useful over there.
Welcome to the Hallucigen Labs observation area. Please step up to the windows for a demonstration of our products in development.
Sweet.
A chemical leak has been detected. Please evacuate the building.
Hallucigens Eradicator provides your forces with a state-of-the-art field decontamination solution. High amounts of residual radiation may persist in the infected area. Dosage subject to change pending safety evaluations. Invisiwave from Hallucigen is a new advance in the field of stealth technology, capable of doing away with cumbersome personal generators forever. Some subjects may become inaudible and or intangible. Effects may be found, and further research is ongoing. On the market, and without the messy side effects of our competitors' offerings. Use with caution. Unpredictable sensory experiences may result. Subjects exposed to high dosages may suffer catastrophic adrenal failure. Hallucinogens dispersant is ideal for peacefully clearing an area of civilians.
A chemical leak has been detected.
Hallucinogen is not responsible for any damage, injury, or loss of life sustained in mass panics that may or may not result from the use of dispersant.
Okay. Oh, I don't know. I think I'd make a pretty neat ghoul. How do you think, Piper? I mean, I have the life experience for it. You know, been around for 200 years. I make the jump like 3 times before, and now I can't make the jump at all. Game be trolling me.
Please evacuate the building.
Game, seriously, let me move. Anything else worth looting?
A chemical leak has been detected. Please evacuate the building.
Like, suddenly I can't make any of these jumps, which is ridiculous. Considering I did that catwalk walk. I was like, nope, now you can't make any of the jumps. Shwa-da-da-da-da. Yeah, it wasn't really worth it, was it?
Repeat. A chemical leak has been detected. Please evacuate the building immediately.
Bunny? Lab access terminal. That's a big minigun.
Repeat, a chemical leak has been detected. Please evacuate the building immediately.
There we go. Thank you.
gotta be in there. Well, that means that the staircase going up that I initially ignored must lead to some supplementary loot.
Repeat, a chemical leak has been detected. Please evacuate the building immediately.
We leveled up a while ago, and I still haven't even looked at the perk list to figure out what to do with it. Let's do that now. Toughness. Last rank of toughness. That was easy enough. So now we have a base defense of what? 273 of all of our gear on. Not bad. The question is what to start investing in next. I'm thinking probably refractor, so I can get a base energy resist of 50. Seems like a good combo. Build up my defenses, because my offense is pretty good. I've got all the offensive skills now for every weapon. The only thing after that is like the ones that improve VAPs in various ways. Maybe get Life Giver as well in part of this next process. Because having more health and more defenses is not a bad combo. Decontamination chamber. Thank you. Trying to find a secret of Nuka-Cola Quantum. Seems like that was it.
Repeat, a chemical leak has been detected. Please evacuate.
Investigate the radio broadcast directly to the south of us. Boston Public Library. What else? That's way up there to do. Kill the raiders. So, let's see. Well, we can do these two, then probably head to Shaw. And that, as they're in the general area. But then we'll have to do completely separate trips for these, for that and that, because they're on completely separate sides of the map. Oh, Huber's Comics. We've got to go into Huber's Comics. Where? Huber's Comics and Toys. Any more? Are there any more? Where? So are you running off on your own, Piper? No, we're not safe. Permanently gain 1% chance of avoiding all damage from an attack. Interesting. Said there was a safe. Where's the safe? You know, it occurs to me that if these are the ghouls who basically were working here when the bombs fell, that means technically one of the ghouls here is Grognak, and one of the ghouls here is the Silver Shroud. Let that sink in for a moment. That might have been Grognak. You know, one of these days I'm going to make a mod where you can actually turn these things into something useful. I'm not sure what. Because, I mean, if I were to make them turn into skill books, I'd probably have to create a whole new set of skill books and skill book effects. And that requires actually thinking up the logistics of what type of skill perks do I want to create. You know, what from the Lost Grognak comics would make sense as a perk? So it doesn't mess with the vanilla stuff. And figure out what the requirements are. Do you need science, for example, to repair these things? So give me your thoughts. What would make sense for the repaired comic books? And ruined books as well. Not just the comic books, but the ruined books as well. The only thing I won't really touch is the overdue books, since they're quest related. Scavenger's note. Oh, Jangles, I completely understand why you would start drinking. Where are they, Piper? Scavenger's List. Piper, careful! Nearly shot you in the face! You wandering around like that. Seriously, Piper, stop sneaking up on me. Say something when you're getting close. And don't tell me you can't hear me coming. I mean, I'm not exactly the most subtle of people with this weapon. Don't tell me. You have no idea where I am, Piper. Thank you. Well, that was anticlimactic, wasn't it? Up higher, I think. I know there was a staircase up, so why am I being so blind and not able to find it again? Are you the Silver Shroud? I think that might have been the Silver Shroud. Somehow I was expecting the Silver Shroud to be a bit tougher. What do I know?
Yes.
Apparently the Silver Shroud reads Awesome Tales. Which gives me a perk for the Alien Blaster, which I don't have. Actually, I haven't seen the alien ship crash in this playthrough. Kind of strange. Second Piper, in a second. We'll have loot to grab. There is stuff back there that I don't think I've ever noticed. Silver submachine gun prop.
Hey, just let me know.
Hey, Piper. For you, Piper? 2 minutes. Hell, maybe even 2.5.
Oh, great. Weird, but great. Just what you said about Nat. I've been going over it again and again in my head. And
you mean that she's a sin?
You said was right. I'm not going to be the deciding factor in what becomes of Nat. She's going to figure that out for herself. It's just, sometimes it feels like the only things I've got in life are Nat and the paper. Having someone I can count on, someone like you, it's meant a lot to me. Not a lot of people want to hang around with a nosy reporter.
Well, in case you hadn't noticed, yes, because we're the grumpy type.
Quit pitying yourself. You've got a home, a job, your sister. Things aren't that bad.
No, you're right. I just never expected it all to cost so much. I mean, when I started the paper, I just wanted to write the things I thought were wrong. And when Nat and I first got to Diamond City, there was a lot of wrong. Guards, lousy infrastructure. There was a hole in the exterior wall that was patched over with a bookcase. One bookcase. That's it. I started the paper more as an act of desperation than anything else. Turned out I wasn't the only one who wanted things to change. After the first couple of editions, people may not have agreed with what I said, but everyone was listening.
Yes, the grumpy
still
answer.
A lot of work to fix that town.
Oh yeah, but it's come a long way. When that first edition hit the stands, I felt like I'd finally done something worth doing. But afterwards, things changed. People didn't want to talk to me. It seemed that overnight, I'd gone from Piper, friend and confidant, to Piper, the nosy snoop.
Well, you are a nosy snoop.
They haven't treated me the same since. It started to feel like the only person I could count on was the little sis.
Can you blame them? You made your living exposing other people's secrets.
I just always hoped they'd understand I was trying to do something good. And some folks have, but it wasn't exactly the life I've been hoping for. Until you came along. You're not afraid of me like everyone else. I was sure that the paper would be the best thing I ever did in my life, but
being here with you now. Now I don't know. I've needed someone like you in my life for a long time, Blue. I just never expected I'd actually get them. Thank you for being the friend I can count on.
It sounds to me like you're interested in becoming more than just friends.
Oh, I mean, I'm lying if I said I never thought about you that way. Not that I'm always thinking about it. It's just, Blue, I'm loud and pushy and constantly getting in over my head. Why would someone like you ever want someone like me?
All we've been through, I've already seen you at your worst.
And you're still here, aren't you? Goodness, Blue, I don't know what to say. You're everything I could ever ask for. Come on, let's not keep the world waiting.
Because I have reached the highest level of affinity with Piper, I have gained the gift of gab, which means now I can immediately dismiss her. Pick up Kate. Sorry, Piper, I'm just using you for your companion perk. Finally, here's an interesting question. Now that we've mapped out Piper, can we go for MacReady or Kate? Here we go. Let's see, radio, freedom, inventory, weapons.
Fire mission complete. Signing off.
Help on Mayday or whatever it is one says. My name is Rex Goodman. I'm being held personally on the top of the Trinity Tower.
I think we may have broken the game. Well, this is as good a place to end as any, isn't it? We'll do Trinity Tower next time. Well, see.